Hi guys, welcome to the 13th episode recap of Law School. The episode starts with the judge announcing the end of the hearing and handing over to the jury to make their decision. Mun-ho, on the other hand, drags the man Joon-hwi saw at the prison to his house and beats him up. Joon-hwi sees them through the installed CCTV camera. After a while, Mun-ho arrives and smashes the CCTV camera with a rock. Joon-hwi and Soo-jae runs to Soo-jae's neighborhood, realizing something is wrong. Soo-jae goes to check on her sister, while Joon-hwi checks Mun-ho's house. Joon-hwi finds the man tied up and wearing Mun-ho's anklet. In the meantime, as Mun-ho prepares to kill Joon-hoon, Joon-hoon realizes that it was Mun-ho who killed Prosecutor Seo. He is also surprised to see that Mun-ho has managed to lose his anklet. When Joon-ho asks him why he killed Prosecutor Seo when he even got him out of the prison, Mun-ho confessed that he wanted to find his son and got no choice but to do it. Just as Mun-ho is about to inject the drug, he gets a call from the monitoring center asking for his whereabouts. When Mun-ho tells them that he's at home, Joon-hoon yells that he's not and kicks Mun-ho. They wrestle, but Mun-ho manages to pin Joon-hoon to the ground. As Mun-ho starts to inject the drug, Joon-hwi comes with two police officers and saves Joon-hoon. As the two prosecutors wait for the verdict, the prosecutor tells to the chief prosecutor not to bribe the jurors as he used to, since she wants to play fair and square. At the jury's deliberation, Soo-jae's mother snores loudly as the others discuss about the case. Apparently, she's just an alternative juror and do not get to take part in deciding the verdict unless one of the main jurors are absent. When the other jurors wakes her up and complains about her snoring, Soo-jae's mother shouts at them for not concluding the case as self-defense when it is obvious. She reminds them of Soo-jae's justification of the situation. We then flash back to Soo-jae acting out with Joon-hoon's attorney to properly explain the geocam footage. Geo is troubled about what the chief prosecutor told him about his father not knowing what he was up against. He makes a call to Seul-bi, but she hangs it up since she is lost in her own mess. She remembers her talk with Joon-hwi. He is correctly assumed that Seul-bi's mother has made her plagiarize Prosecutor Seo's paper. So Joon-hwi has wanted to help her escape her mother. He has invited her into the study group for that reason. He tells her that he would have accepted her into the school even without the paper, and encouraged her to admit for plagiarizing and hope for the best. Joon-hoon, on the other hand, experienced the effect of drugs for the first time. Joon-hwi has found out that the name of the man found at Mun-ho's house is Choi Jae-chol, and that he has worked for an ankle monitor manufacturer. He and Mun-ho has met in the prison during Jae-chol's service for embezzlement. It was Jae-chol who has helped Mun-ho to remove his ankle monitor. The judge announced the verdict and admit the trial as self-defense, and Ye-seul's friends applaud in delight. On hearing the news, Assemblyman Ko orders his secretary to send Young Chung to a rural hospital so no reporter could find him. Over in Myeolundin, they learn the Bad Fama trial also has been ruled in the web operator's favor, mainly because of the new bill introduced by Assemblyman Ko. Professor Kim notes Soo-jae's disappointment. Professor Kim meets with Soo-jae outside the restaurant. She confessed to Soo-jae, even though Assemblyman Ko benefit from the bill, she was desperate to win the Bad Fama trial. She also tells her that she is the one who gave the Lee Mun-ho Act to the Assemblyman, even though Joon-hoon claims it was Kang-dun. Soo-jae is surprised to hear this and tell her that Kang-dun is her sister. Soo-jae tell her that Dun volunteered at the orphanage Mun-ho's son is in, and has befriended him. The chief prosecutor meets with reporter Choi over a drink. He tells to reporter Choi that he shouldn't be betraying him. He tells him that he leaked the information not because he wanted. The talk gets interrupted by Joon-hoon's call. He tells to the chief prosecutor that Mun-ho is the real culprit and was caught when he was trying to kill him. The chief prosecutor rushed to the police station and questions Mun-ho. But he refused to answer until he gets himself a lawyer. Seul-bi tells to her parents that she has decided to confess about the plagiarism. Even though her mother begs her not to, Seul-bi tells her she must, since Joon-hoon is giving her time to confess because of Joon-hwi, and leaves to her room. The next day, Joon-hwi and Ye-bom present the evidence they have against Mun-ho, which prove Mun-ho is the culprit. The chief prosecutor meets with the assemblyman to inform him about Mun-ho. The assemblyman tells him that he has stopped reporters from publishing about Mun-ho's arrestment. He advised him to convince Choi Jae-chol to make it look like the chief prosecutor caught the real culprit. He also tells to hand that exclusive news to report Choi and make him walk back his statement to the prosecutors. Since reporter Choi has walked back on the statement, Geo meets with the two detectives who investigated Joon-hoon's case and asked to testify. When they refuse, Geo confess that because of the chief prosecutor, he lost his father. One of the detectives also gets a text from Joon-hoon saying helping Geo is the right way to apologize to him. At the assemblyman's office, Soo-jae notices a photograph of the assemblyman holding up a toy in his hand with his head supporter. The assemblyman's assistant tells to Soo-jae that she and Seul-bi are dismissed from their internships. Seul-bi confessed to the dean and Professor Kim that she did plagiarize the paper and hopes that she won't be kicked out of the school because of it. At the prosecutor's office, Joon-hee and Yi-bum runs into the two detectives after they testify. Mun-ho demands to cross-examine with Choi Jae-chul. To his surprise, the assemblyman's attorney represents Choi Jae-chul, but no one shows up for Mun-ho. He makes a call from the attorney's phone, and tells to the caller that this is not what he promised. As he leaves, he looks at Joon-hee and tells him that even though he's smart, he's missing a crucial point. Professor Kim tells to Jung-hoon that in her application, Seo Bi has not mentioned about the award she got for her plagiarized paper, even though she has attached a copy of the certificate. So the school has not considered the award for her admission. The vice dean hands his resignation letter again to the dean, and tells her that you will leave this time, even if she tear the letter. He tells her to punish Seo Bi by the law of the school, and leaves. Over a meal, Seo Bi asks Jio about the progress of his father's case. She shows him a photo of Assemblyman Ko, and the Ibit Toy Company CEO who was both Jio's father's competitor, and Assemblyman Ko's head supporter. He finally realized what the chief prosecutor said to him the other day. Jio goes straight to see the chief prosecutor, and asks him if the Assemblyman and Ibit CEO is behind his father's death. Yi-bum drags Jio out of the office. Joon-hee asks for some privacy with Jio. Jio realized that Joon-hee knew about this from the start, and refused to tell him. Joon-hee admits to it and tell him that it is because he knew he'd act this way, even though he is well aware that it would bring him no good. Joon-hee heads back and tells to the chief prosecutor that he has decided to help Jio to indict him. So he requests to replace him under the supervision of Prosecutor Lee, who is investigating on the chief prosecutor's case. As Sol-ae heads back after being dismissed, Joon-hoon's attorney drives past her and takes her to his office. He tells her to complete her internship with him. When she refuses it, the attorney tells her that he's only offering it to her because Joon-hoon asked him to. She heads back to the school and confronts Joon-hoon about her assignment. He tells her that his attorney, who is Attorney Park, will be taking on Mun-ho's case and ask her to help him during her internship. When she continued to refuse, Joon-hoon reminds her that even a criminal has a right to defend. Joon-hoon goes to see Mun-ho in the prison. He asks him to cooperate, since he got him a lawyer, and it seemed as the one who gave him the contract has abandoned him. But he refused to say anything. At the dorm, Joon-hee writes a complaint against the chief prosecutor. After filling halfway through, Joon-hee leaves to take a shower, warning Jio not to go near his desk. But once he's gone, Jio fills up the complaint, and Joon-hee watches him from behind. The next day, Joon-hoon gets a call from Mun-ho asking him to meet with him immediately. As he goes to the prison, an ambulance goes past him. On seeing it, Joon-hoon runs to the reception, and asks if it was Mun-ho in the ambulance. He runs to the hospital and finds Mun-ho almost passing out. He tries to whisper the name of the person who gave him the order, but he dies before he could. Assemblyman's attorney goes to the same place Mun-ho went, and reports that Choi Jae-chul's bail request was processed, and that he got released. When he mentioned about Mun-ho, the man turns his chair, revealing the person behind Mun-ho was the assemblyman. With that, the episode ends. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Please consider to subscribe, like, comment and share this video, since it'll help this channel so much. I hope to see you again in our channel.